For 4 years, we've documented Gretchen and Slade's journey to parenthood. Just a few months ago, they welcomed their daughter, Skyler Gray, who joins us for her television debut. Hey, Skyler Gray. What do you think of all this?
Say hi to everybody in the audience. Yeah.
Adorable.
So let's talk all things Skyler.
Yes.
You know, how's Skyler doing?
We just made it through that bewitching hour, where I think her digestive tract changes a little. This was according to our pediatrician. So she was having some trouble digesting, and they start spitting up a lot. But she is now sleeping 6 hours?
6 to 7 hours,
well,
yeah.
That's great.
Yeah. So, I mean, it wasn't like that.
Right.
Thank you. It was not like that at the beginning, don't get me wrong. It was every couple hours for sure, if not every hour. And because, as I was saying, I was breastfeeding, so it was just every minute. But yeah, now she's sleeping like a little bit through the night, and then we had that 5 to 6 week mark that was really tough. We all of a sudden were like, oh my gosh, we have a colicky baby, what happened? Like, why is she crying all the time and so upset? So we got through that stage, and now she's just doing great. Like, we feel like we have a pattern down now with her, and we feel like we're understanding her, we're understanding her cues.
You look like a pro over there, Slade.
Every couple goes through that, the fear of having a colicky baby, and you know, all babies have that period. Yeah. For a couple of months, that their so-called witching hour, where they're restless, and it probably is just a developmental thing, with the GI tract, and they get through it, but it can test you.
Well, you know, we didn't realize that. You know, there's books and there's all this stuff, but like they don't really tell you like, okay, if this is happening, get gas medicine or do this or do it. Like the simplest little things fixes it. But you are like, oh my gosh, we're a bad parent. We don't know how to like calm our baby down. They're crying 24/7. You know, like you start questioning yourself with everything.
Yeah.
Thank goodness for him. He's been my rock because he's had two boys before this.
That's what you have to learn to be a team.
Yeah.
And that's part of getting through that when one of you gets to that point, it's a handoff.
Yeah. Yes.
Hand off the baby and switch it up. Change environment.
Yeah.
The baby can pick up a different scent from each of you. That may help soothe the baby. Uh-huh. So
we're doing
you
that
learn.
Constantly. It's back. Yeah. Okay, Dad, you try.
Back in the day,
you
Drew.
Try.
Well, the little things that I just mentioned, just trying to distract them and change it up a little
look
bit.
At you.
Look at me then.
Look at you.
Look at you. With their little blue eyes.
See, those are mommy's eyes, the blue eyes.
Do you want some more?
You want this more? You've had so much.
That's actually a thing that I wanted to ask
you guys. Yeah, go ahead, we're here.
About the feeding. This girl eats so much food. I'm like, how does she consume that much food?
We've jumped a percentile.
Yeah.
As far as on the growth chart, she just really spiked, so.
Yeah, she just loves to eat all the time. So my question is, can you overfeed a baby?
Well, I think you just want to make sure she's growing appropriately. So it's really important to follow up with your pediatrician and just making sure you're staying on track with that. Right. But babies will typically let you know when they've had enough. I mean, she'll do things like close her mouth, or she'll turn her head, or maybe you're feeding her and she'll just fall asleep while she's eating.
Right.
That means she's had enough. And just in general, when babies are going through growth spurts, they tend to eat a little more. So just look out for that.
Yeah.
And it's so great to hear that too, because there's so much information between what the nurse may tell you at the hospital versus your pediatrician. And one of the doctors said, she should only be having 4 ounces. I'm like, have you met our daughter?
She wants more than that.
4 ounces ain't gonna do it.
Yeah, but make sure she's growing appropriately.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we just had our pediatrician visit and they said that she was great, but I don't know. It seems like she wants
food. She's just hungry.
She's just hungry.
She's just hungry.
Yeah.
Huh.
She's hungry.
Well, we have loved being a part of your journey, and we actually have a little something for you for Skyler. It's a little bit silly, but
oh my gosh.
That's amazing.
You guys, that's so sweet. What is oh that is so cute, you guys. Look.
That is the best.
That is so cute.
That's amazing.
Oh my gosh. Sky, you're gonna look so cute in this. Look, it matches your hair go already.
You're gonna be a doctor.
Thank you guys so much. Oh yeah, we're already saying she's gonna be a doctor.
She's
love it.
She's gonna intern with Dr. Nita.
Hey, send her over. I'm ready.
Aw, yeah. You guys, that's
thank
so
you so
sweet.
Much.
Thank
well, we're
so, happy for you.
So very thank happy you. For the two of you
thank
and
you.
The many journeys you will have down the road with Skyler Gray. And thank you for sharing all
thank
of this
you.
With us.